Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series on the medieval history. In this medieval history, today on we are the words of the last part of this medieval history, that is the Mughals. The major influence of the medieval history on your examination will be from the art and architecture side. That what all these rulers, let it be Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shaghi, Shah Jahan or Aurangzeb, did architecturally and painting wise, that is the most important thing which has to be taken care of. In today's lecture, I shall be giving you a very brief idea about Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan and Aurangzeb. What all these people did or how was the sequence of these individuals. So, a quick overview about these things. First is the Babur. See, last time we have seen that there was Ibrahim Lodi who was ruling India. In this Lodi dynasty, he was the last king of the Lodi dynasty, and he was very much, you can say, sarcastic in his views, and he always humiliated his nobles. And we have seen the case of Daulat Khan. So Daulat Khan invited Babur to come to India and take the revenge from the Ibrahim Lodi. So Babur came to India in 1526. Earlier he defeated Ibrahim Lodi itself in the western side, and after that he came to India in 1526, and in 1526 the first battle of Panipat took place. Panipat ki ladai hui, and in this battle of Panipat, Babur defeated Ibrahim Lodi, and with this he came to India. Now, if I talk about this Babur, friends, who was Babur? Babur was an individual whose original name was Zahir-ud-Din Muhammad. Zahir-ud-Din Muhammad. Zahir-ud-Din Muhammad is his original name tha, and he was from Afghan. From mother side he was from Chinggis Khan, and from father side he was from Taimur-Lung. So Taimur-Lung kaun tha jisne India pe attack kiya tha Sayyid dynasty se pehle aur Tughlaq dynasty se baad aur Sayyid dynasty se pehle. To uski taraf se Babur tha from Taimur side also, and another one was from Chinggis Khan. In dono ki taraf se tha, and he came to India and he fought with this. Now his father was Umar Sheikh Mirza. Father Umar Sheikh Mirza. His father was Umar Sheikh Mirza, who was, you can say, ruling the area of Farghana, F-A-R-G-H-A-N-A, who was ruling the area of Farghana. So these are the few details. After coming to India, on the eve of coming to India, he was having many, you can say, individuals whom he has to be dealt with. Like he was having Delhi Sultanate, he was having Vijayanagar Empire, he was Rana Sangha, he was having Malwa, Bengal. These ke sare jo area se, they were totally against this individual. He defeated Daulat Khan. Daulat Khan, as I told you, he defeated Ibrahim Lodi, as I told you, and there is, he also defeated Rana Sangha. He defeated Rana Sangha in the Battle of Khanua. Battle of Khanua. Rana Sangha ko isne defeat kiya. So his mother tongue was Turkish. Now this was the detail of the Babur. Now coming to the next part, Babur ke baad jo agla part aata hai, wo aata hai aapka Humayun ka. Humayun ka, Humayun, if you talk about this word Humayun, Humayun means fortune. Fortune. Lekin ye irony hai history ki, that this individual Humayun never had a good fortune. In fact, he was having a misfortune. Misfortune means hamesha iske saath galat hi hua hai. For example, see, Humayun ruled India for 1530 to 1540 for 15 years. For 15 years he was not in India. 15 saal tak wo desh mein nahi tha. He fled India, and after 15 years he came back. In 1555 he again came back, and from 1555 to 1556 he again ruled India. Uske baad wo library mein gir jata hai and uski death ho jati hai, and then comes the Akbar. So ye do parts hai. First part is the 1530 to 1540 where he tried to consolidate his power, and in 1555 to 1556 he tried to retake its power from the individuals, those who have taken it forcibly. And during the reign of 15 years, who ruled over India? This was Sher Shah, or you can say Sur dynasty. So Sur dynasty came in between from 1540 to 1555. Sher Shah specifically ruled from 1540 to 1545. So this was a major impact that you have to remember, that Humayun came, and the Humayun was the son of the Babur. After Humayun, Humayun means fortune, but unfortunately he was not that fortunate to have good fortune. So first thing is, he had three brothers. Iske teen brothers hai. Brothers, three. One was Kamran, K-A-M-R-A-N, Kamran, Askari. Askari was the second one, and third one was Hindal. He defeated, he distributed his entire region, jitna bhi iska region tha, wo sara ka sara region usne in teen do apne bhaiyon mein baant diya. Kabul aur Kandahar jo tha wo Kamran ke paas tha. Kabul, Kandahar iske paas tha, in dono ke paas Sambhal and Alwar, matlab western part in dono ke paas de diya gaya. Western part. So he distributed his entire region amongst his brothers. A very good relationship between brothers. So finally he went to the war with the Afghans. Afghan ke saath jab wo lad raha tha, Sher Khan ke saath, at that point of time he heard the news that the Bahadur Shah of Gujarat is attacking or is marching towards Delhi. Bahadur Shah of Gujarat is attacking Delhi. So when he heard that Bahadur Shah of Gujarat is attacking Delhi, he had a treaty with Sher Khan, peace treaty with Sher Khan, and returned to Gujarat to fight with the Bahadur Shah. He defeated Bahadur Shah, and after defeating Bahadur Shah, he distributed or he handed over that part to the Eastern brothers, the Askari and the Hindal. Inko ye de diya gaya. Meanwhile, after the fight, the Sher Khan again rose to the power and they again challenged the Mughal Sultanate. So, not Sultanate, but Mughal army. So, in the Battle of Chausa, these are important. Battle of Khanua, Battle of Chausa, Mughal army was totally defeated. So Mughal, in the 1539, the Mughal army was defeated. After that, he went to his brother and for help. But all these brothers were non-cooperatives. They did not cooperate with Humayun. And Humayun had to face the battle all alone. And he fought the battle of Kannauj. So Battle of Kannauj took place in the 1540, in which Mughal Emperor Humayun was defeated. Now when Mughal Emperor Humayun was defeated, he fled it and he left for the Persia along with his wife. And during the way to Persia, he was blessed with a son, and the name of the son was Akbar. So in 1540, he left India, and there came the rule of Sher Shah. In Sher Shah, Sher Shah's original name, if I talk about Sher Shah, his original name was Farid. Iska original naam tha Farid. Farid ke baad his father was Hasan Khan. Father name Hasan Khan, and they were in Bihar. Or वहाँ पे बिहार का जो इंडिविजुअल था, जो वहाँ पे रूल कर रहा था, अफगान रूलर, he gave the title of Sher Shah to this Farid as he was for his bravery. So after this he came to the power. His entire region was divided into 47 parts, and these 47 parts were known as sarkars. In 47 parts, or you can say Sher Shah entire region was distributed into 47 sarkars, and these sarkars were further divided into districts and all. These sarkars, in each and every sarkar there were two individuals. One was Chief Shikdar and Chief Munsif. So remember, Chief Shikdar and Chief Munsif. ये दो हर एक शिकदर सरकार में लोग हुआ करते थे. सो दीज वर द इंडिविजुअल्स ऑफ दिस शिकदार, मुनसिफ Chief Sikdar and Chief Munsif. Apart from it, he also built an extensive network of the roadways. He built four roadways. Along with the four roadways, he also started with the building of the rest houses. So rest houses usne banaye aur ye sari cheezein ki. And after the death of Sher Shah, the emperor, were not that much strong. And one more thing that has to be noticed. Sorry, friends. The thing is, he also introduced silver coins. Silver coins, those were known as the dam or dam. Okay, so he also used to do this. Okay, after that, his successors were not that much strong. And in the year 1555, Humayun came back and he took all his power back and he defeated all his brothers and he again tried to consolidate his empire. So in 1555, after 1555, in 1556, when he was in library, he slipped over there and he died over there. So in the year 1556, Humayun died, and at the time of the death of Humayun, Akbar was very you can say not that much prudent to have entire Mughal part to be run alone. So he was having an individual known as the Bairam Khan as his regent. So under the Bairam Khan was a very able and very wise individual who taught Akbar each and every aspect. And after that, he had a second battle of Panipat in Delhi. In the second battle of Panipat, what happened there, it was a Hemu was an individual who was having his throne in the Delhi. So Akbar fought with him in the second battle of Panipat. When these two forces fought, Akbar was on the verge of losing this battle, but to the fortune of Akbar, an arrow struck the eye of Hemu, and the army of the Hemu fled from the position. So army jo Hemu ki army thi wo wahan se bhag gayi. This led to the victory of Akbar, aur usse aage Akbar hamesha grow karta raha. So there is a case of Panipat. In Panipat you have Hemu. And after this, Akbar knew that India is a country of diversity, and for the purpose of consolidating his power, what he did, he married to a Hindu princess, and this Hindu princess was a daughter of Bharmal. Yaad rakhiyega, Jodha bhai jisko hum kehte hain, Bharmal. Bharmal ki wo daughter thi, and she was the daughter of Bharmal, and he married, and with this marriage, Hindus and somewhere you can say the Rajputs of the Rajasthan area, they were not having a very cordial relation, but after this marriage they had a very cordial relationship. So if I talk about the religious policy of Akbar, or if I talk about the consolidation of the empire, Akbar did it with the matrimonial alliances and accepting other religions into his own religion. Next example is he even gave space to Hindus in his nine Navratans. इसमें नवरत्न हुआ करते थे अकबर के कोर्ट में. उसमें तीन हिंदू किंग थे, हिंदू इंडिविजुअल थे. वन वॉज बीरबल, अनदर वन वॉज टोडरमल, एंड द थर्ड वन वॉज मानसिंह. ये तीन लोग भी थे. दिस शोज दैट अकबर वॉज नॉट दैट मच यू कैन से एक्सटेंसिव और यू कैन से ऑर्थोडॉक्स मुस्लिम, वेयर ही ऑलवेज रिजेक्टेड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ हिंदूज एंड मुस्लिम्स, सॉरी ऑफ हिंदू सुप्रीमेसी. सो ही इंट्रोड्यूस अमंग्स नाइन थ्री इंडिविजुअल्स वर देयर who are having the direct access to the king. So amongst those, the Man Singh is important. Why Man Singh? Birbal, we know. Todarmal is for revenue. Man Singh is important. Why? Because he fought the battle of Haldi Ghati. ये हल्दी घाटी की इसने लड़ाई लड़ी, और हल्दी घाटी की लड़ाई लड़ी बिटवीन राणा प्रताप सिंह एंड मान सिंह. तो राणा प्रताप सिंह को हराया गया इन दिस बैटल. सो हल्दी घाटी की लड़ाई इसलिए इंपॉर्टेंट थी. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, ही ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड द uniform religion, where you can say that the important postulates from the Hinduism as well as the important postulates from the Muslims were joined together, and it was known as Deen-e-Ilahi. No doubt this Deen-e-Ilahi religion was a failure because it was having all in all 15 followers only, Birbal being the one who was following this religion, but it was not up to that much, you can say, expectations of the people. But he tried to consolidate or try to mix the people of Hinduism and Muslims into one fabric. So it was this. Another aspect of Akbar was Mansabdari system. He introduced Mansabdari system. Mansabdari system means mansabs, means ranks. So there were the ranks which were introduced, and these ranks were not hereditary. These ranks were on the basis of the, you can say, work done by the individuals. So जैसे जैसे इनकी अपने काम हुआ करते थे इनको वैसे वैसे मनसब मनसब मिला करता था. So मनसबदारी system was also introduced by Akbar. After Akbar, there was his son was Jahangir. Jahangir throne में आया. And for the case of Jahangir, there is only one thing that we are always concerned about is Jahangir के साथ हमेशा एक नाम जुड़ता है, that is Noor Jahan. नूर जहां और मेरुनिसा. फर्स्ट थिंग, जहांगीर के टाइम रिबेलियन बहुत हुए. रिबेलियन होने का मतलब यह था, इन द नॉर्थ देयर वाज सिक्स हु वाज रिबेलिंग अगेंस्ट जहांगीर. एंड इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट 1605 टू 1627, डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द टाइम व्हेन ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी फ्रॉम ब्रिटेन ऑल्सो ट्राइड टू कम टू इंडिया. बिकॉज इन द ईयर 1599 ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ अकबर it was established, the East India Act was passed, whereas in the time, during the time of Jahangir, it tried to come to India in 1605 to 1627. So the entire scenario in the world was changing. This kingship was changing into the colonization. So in India, they were trying to do the trade because India was very much famous. So rebellion was there. Again, one more thing is, he beheaded the Sikh Guru, the fifth Sikh Guru, Guru Arjan Dev Ji. So he beheaded him, the fifth guru, guru of Sikh. Wo behead kiya gaye by this Jahangir. Apart from it, he married Noor Jahan or Mehrunisa in the 1611. Mehrunisa, who was Mehrunisa? He was a daughter, she was a daughter of his noble. Aur usme sabse badi baat kya thi? Noor Jahan had Noor Jahan had her brother, elder brother, and the name of the elder brother was Asaf Khan. Asaf Khan. Asaf Khan isko kaha, uska naam tha Asaf Khan. He was appointed as Khan-e-Saman by Akbar. Khan Saman by Akbar. This post was always, you can say, reserved for the individuals of the nobles. So it was out of the track where Jahangir went and said that, okay, he will be having this aspect of Khan Saman. Apart from it, Noor Jahan ka brother Asaf Khan, Asaf Khan ki beti hui, the name of the Asaf Khan beti was Arjumand Banu Begum. Now, who is this Arjunmand Banu Begum? Arjunmand Banu Begum was Mumtaz, wife of Shah Jahan. So, Noor Jahan ka bhai Asaf Khan ka ki beti Arjun Banu Begum, jisko Mumtaz ke naam se bhi jante hain, Mumtaz was the wife of Shah Jahan. So again, this Jahangir was having scuffle with Akbar. Why he was having scuffle with Akbar? Because at times Jahangir was following his wife Noor Jahan. Noor Jahan even accompanied him to the various hunting tours, and even at the gates or at the court, and everywhere Noor Jahan was following Jahangir. So somewhere he was having a scuffle with Akbar. So with this, Noor Jahan was also one more thing is important, that Noor Jahan was implementing or bringing in India the fashion of Persia. So Persia ka jo fashion tha wo Noor Jahan yahan India mein leke aayi thi. So this, for this aspect also the Noor Jahan is important. The next individual is now Shah Jahan. Now Shah Jahan was an individual who was the, you can say, was Not that much aggressive, but he tried to move towards the north, towards the Afghans, where he lost somewhere around 5,000 men. After losing 5,000 men in the north, he left the idea of further moving to the north, and he came towards the south. And in south, Golconda and all other aspects or all other cities were again taken back by the Shah Jahan into his empire. So Shah Jahan ke andar ye tha ki he also built many temples, like for his wife Mumtaz, he built not temples but beautiful mosque. He built beautiful mosques, and he also built the Taj Mahal in Agra. So Agra mein isko Taj Mahal rakha gaya. And after Shah Jahan, there was a battle of succession between Dara Sikho. The first one was Dara Sikho. The second one was Shuja. Third, Aurangzeb. Zeb. And fourth one was Murad Bakhsh. Murad Bakhsh, jo tha, he was in charge of Gujarat. Aurangzeb, Deccan. Shuja was Bengal. And Dara Singh, Crown Prince. So there was a war of succession between Dara Sikho, Dara, Shuja, Aurangzeb and Murad Bakhsh. Now these individuals fought amongst themselves for the supremacy when Shah Jahan fell ill. And Aurangzeb was in the Deccan. Agar Aurangzeb Deccan mein tha, to Deccan mein there rose to one more individual, rose to the power, that was the Shivaji and the other individuals. So ab Shivaji agar power mein aa gaya yahan se, to yahan iski wajah se kya hoga ki ye jo Aurangzeb hai, ये कहीं ना कहीं दिक्कत में रहेगा विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द डेक्कन. सो आफ्टर दैट औरंगजेब केम, एंड व्हेन औरंगजेब केम टू द पावर, औरंगजेब सीज्ड एंड ट्राई टू कंट्रोल द एंटायर पार्ट आफ्टर 1658, आफ्टर डिफीटिंग ऑल हिज ब्रदर्स. सो 1658 में वो पावर में आया, और पावर में आने के बाद ही इंगल्फ्ड हिमसेल्फ फॉर 25 ईयर्स फॉर द ईस्टर्न पार्ट, सॉरी डेक्कन पार्ट. तो ये डेक्कन पार्ट में 25 साल तक चला रहा, और 25 साल तक ये डेक्कन को ही सॉल्व करता रहा. मीनवाइल औरंगजेब वाज अ वेरी, यू कैन से, ऑर्थोडॉक्स मुस्लिम, वेयर ही नेवर टॉलरेटेड द अदर रिलीजियस सेंटीमेंट्स, ही नेवर रिस्पेक्टेड अदर रिलीजियस सेंटीमेंट्स. एंड इवन ड्यूरिंग हिज रेन ही वॉज ऑलवेज अगेंस्ट द ड्रिंकिंग, ही बैंड ड्रिंकिंग इन द रीजन. एंड एट द सेम टाइम ही ऑल्सो सेड दैट नो वन विल बी ग्रोइंग ड्रग्स, ड्रग्स मीन्स भांग एंड ऑल, नो वन विल बी ग्रोइंग इट. सो ही वॉज अ वेरी ऑर्थोडॉक्स मुस्लिम ऑफ हिज एज. ही फॉरबेड म्यूजिक ऑल्सो, नो वन विल बी हियरिंग द म्यूजिक. सो इसने म्यूजिक को भी बंद कर दिया. आफ्टर म्यूजिक वॉट ही डिड दैट, ही एग्जीक्यूटेड 9th गुरु तेग बहादुर जी. So he executed 9th guru of Sikhism, Tegh Bahadur ji, and after that he re-imposed jizya. उसने जजिया भी रीइम्पोज कर दिया. अगर आप इन सारी चीजों को देखते हो, देन यू विल बी वेरी मच क्लियर विद द थॉट दैट औरंगजेब वाज एन इंडिविजुअल हु इज ऑलवेज यूज्ड टू डू वन थिंग, दैट इज ही ऑलवेज प्रमोटेड मुस्लिम कल्चर. बट इफ ही वाज प्रमोटिंग द मुस्लिम कल्चर एंड द टाइम इज समवेयर 1658 टू 1707, द वर्ल्ड इज कमिंग टू इंडिया, अ न्यू रिलीजन इज कमिंग टू इंडिया, दैट इज अ क्रिश्चियनिटी. सो पीपल विल नॉट टॉलरेट औरंगजेब एज ही हैज टेकन द एज ही हैव डेवलप्ड एनिमोसिटी बिटवीन Mughals and Marathas, or you can say Rajputs of the South. He has taken his animosity, or he has developed animosity between Mughals and Sikh by beheading or by killing the Sikh guru, executing the Sikh gurus. And he also had kind of animosity with the Hindus, because he was plundering the temples, but now he was completely destroying the temples of the Hindus. So इसे सभी धर्मों से जब इसने issue create कर लिए, this led to the major, you can say, or you can reason for the decline of Mughals. So this entire religion or region or Mughal empire came to an end slowly and steadily after Aurangzeb and British East India Company came to the powers. So this was the lecture related to the Mughals. And the architectural aspects will be covered in the art, architecture and paintings class, which is totally different class, and we'll be discussing all these parts in that. Till that lecture, friends, do study and study hard, and refer to the book provided by the academy. Thank you very much.